see your cup? Well, we cannot see your cup. Should we see the cup or no?
No, I'm
not kidding. No, no cup?
No cup.
Sans cup.
No space. No spacce. So you say space in Italian.
Yeah, I was like, Italian
line. Spacce. How do you know, Eric? How do you know what they speak in Italy? I need some more spacce on my computadora. Space on computer.
Oh, do you know? So this is an interesting fact. Computer is computer in every language but one. French is called l'ordinateur.
Isn't like pineapple, we're the only ones that call pineapple? Well, it's like the same word in every other language.
Anana in Spanish.
Anana. Yeah. Margaret just said.
And taxi is taxi in every language. The whole thing with taxi is it's a modern word. It came out after all the languages had been learned.
Well, so did computer. So you're saying that the French people just decided to be French and...
Yep. They just changed it to the ordinator.
Damn you French people.
Welcome.
That was really creepy.
Welcome.
Alright. You go. Okay. I'll watch you.
Welcome. The watch. So the next song is
Hideaway.
Hideaway, song track number 8. I like the instrumentation, don't like the buildup. I like the breakdown, don't like the lyrics. I think metaphor is very straightforward.
Yeah.
They didn't strike me as anything interesting.
You know, I thought that the lyrics, they went along with the album concept.
Yeah.
They're like the next step. He's hiding away from his problems, his wife, his marriage.
They just didn't do it for me, and especially since his voice in this is extremely secondary to the intensity of the music. The music on this is really great, though.
I enjoyed the first part of it, where it's kind of like this like scattered version of the melody's supposed to be, which I thought was cool, but somebody just died.
It was a cat problem. I'm gonna go find the cat.
Hey! What's going on here? Mo?
He gave me some pasta to eat. Just dried pasta.
Kitty Stampede!
Where's Mufasa? Simba. You must remember. The buildup also, it wasn't anything special. Nothing new happened with it. It kind of went on too long because it's just basically lyrics and them singing choral type stuff. So yeah.
Noodles are done.
Noodles are done. These noodles are cooked, ladies and gentlemen, not the ones that Eric gave me earlier.
Unspoken. Don't talk to the camera.
Eric, I don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
I can monologue if I want.
I can leave your friends behind.
You can dance if you want to. You can leave your friends behind. But your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, then they're no friends of mine. Have you ever seen the music video for that?
You can dance if you want to. Don't think it's like, it's not much people just like walking around town.
Yeah, no, they're like, it's like they're at a Renaissance fair. There's like a midget running around too.
No, I have seen it. Yeah, and who is it? Not Flock of Seagulls.
It's Men Without Hats.
Men Without Hats, that's right.
Flock of Seagulls.
So Passion Pit is exactly like Men Without Hats. Let's talk about that.
I'm trying to do this, the haircut.
The Flock of Seagulls haircut. The Flock of Seagulls.
It's like
flop over.
It's like, and then this is like bleep.
Oh.
I read an interview once where they got fed up with their haircut because that's all people wanted to see. They didn't want to see the band. They're like, oh, you guys play music? What would you give this song as a rating?
Oh, probably a 0.6.
I'd give it about a 0.7. 0.7 for that one, which gives an overall rating of 5.8 out of 8. That time I did the math. Technology scares everybody, Eric. We were not meant to know this type of magic. God damn. It's going to start again here in a few seconds.
If the cat doesn't lose his shit first.
The next song on Passion Pit's Gossamer is Two Veils to Hide My Face. Sift within your sense. That was an awesome song.
I mean, it was definitely artistic. It was basically a transition song. You're not going to hear them do that in concert unless they
No, they will definitely do that in concert. Are you kidding me? That would be a sweet way to start a concert.
Oh, to start a concert? I could see that. They're like singing it off stage, and then they come out, then...
That's a weird, like, glitch rock. I like it. The only question about this song, is it auto-tuned?
They might be using a vocoder.
Yeah.
Like on your crazy chord. Because that's what Imogen Heap does.
Yeah. There's no instrumentation to talk about.
You can tell that it's definitely, he's singing, like, just the basic melody. And then the girl is kind of...
They have just left our callous hearts with the bursting rays of August.
There's him and a girl singing octaves, right. And then there's a girl up top singing a very flat line. I wonder how the vocals fit into the title. So two veils to hide my face, yeah. Two girls are obviously singing. You see, fashion fit, getting all...
They're getting on with each other, just veil... Oh, no? Okay, no, threesome. No. Gotcha. Yeah. Right.
I mean, they are called Passion Pit.
All right, what are we going to give that song?
Pit of Passion.
Oh, yeah.
Orgy Pit.
I think it definitely is a transition song. It feels like, we'll have to see what the rest of the album feels
like. Yeah, exactly. But, that's how I was just thinking.
But it definitely feels like this is like the turning point to the next part. Because he's definitely had some dilemmas. He's a drunk. He is a cheater. And he's a big old pumpkin eater.
Peter from Passion Pit.
Peter, pumpkin eater, made a band called Passion Pit. He was a cheater, he was a drinker.
And that girl he never hit.
So, I don't know. We could rate it now, but I think that we should rate it based on an album sense. So we should listen to the rest of the album before we rate it almost.
Okay.
You know?
We're going to take this song and we're going to rate it at the end. Two veils.
We're going to just set it aside for now.
So we got a little bit of a change of pace in song number 10.
Song number 10, yes.
Love is Greed. We have the main character realizing that he's screwed up in the past and that he's about to do it again. Mm-hmm. And he's reflecting and he realizes that his love is just a greedy act.
I feel that the character is disillusioned with love in general, where other songs, he was hopeful about love even though things were going badly for him. He was still striving for that love mentality. In this one, he's saying, how can you love somebody? I mean, if you love yourself at all, how can you love somebody else? One person is dominating, the other person is following, so
yeah.
That duality.
One person loves the other, and the other one loves himself.
Yeah, basically.
I think of someone who's jaded, and he's a broken person, and he's had failed relationships, and he doesn't really put in the effort to actually make it a healthy relationship. His conclusion is based on false premise.
He's been jaded in the past, so, you know, instead of saying, well, I'm gonna try to make this better, he's just kind of like, well, fuck all of it.
One thing that keeps happening over and over on this album is that the music does not match the tone of voice. Usually with sad songs, you get sad music. So maybe it's just a challenging the listener type thing.
You and I both thought that it sounded like a wintry fairyland.
Yeah, I can't get away from that. And I actually don't like the duality all that much.
I definitely did like the background vocals where they were like,
ha, 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 ha. When you did that, it reminded me of Jingle Bells.
Yeah.
And all you do is this.
That's weird, because we were just thinking that it was like
a winter thing. So I wonder if it kind of mimics the...
Maybe he's like trying to go like extremely opposite. Like the happiest time is Christmas time, and well, unless you're, you know, Jewish, they can enjoy sleigh rides.
What if you're Pastafarian? You know?
Pastafars. How do you say just one?
I think the plural is the single.
The plural is a single, so it's not like he's a pasta fart. I think it would be like a pasta fairy. Christmas time for somebody who is alone and disillusioned on love could probably be really depressing in a very depressing time. So he's probably hearing like sleigh bells and stuff, maybe. Yeah.
But with Passion Pit, it's a possibility.
Yeah, you never know.
You never know. He's a pretty arty dude.
I mean, they do have those orgy Passion Pits.
I mean, they have their whole families there, so.
Two veils. Alright, so what are we going to give for a score for this song?
I'd probably say 0.7, yeah. 0.7.
0.7. I got to add it to the
for
total.
For you.
For me.
Mr. Boss.
I am the
boss. Mr. Boss Man.
I'm glad you're finally realizing that I am the boss.
Why am I even here, really?
I should just do this.
Rating these, and I'll just make weird comments just... off camera.
Putting us at...
6.5.